Hi there, this is Ranjit, and I have this Linksys WRT1900 AC Wi-Fi router, and this is a very high-end Wi-Fi router by Linksys. And as you can see, the box is pretty big. Let me take out this plastic and seals, and let's look at this device now. And as you can see, it's a big router. It's a pretty high-end router. Let me talk about the specs. It supports the new AC band, and the model name is WRT1900AC. And if you are an old geek, this design would be very familiar. It's very similar to the WRT54G, which I actually have, and it's a working unit. I'll show you that a bit later. And this supports dual band Wi-Fi. That means it works both on the Wi-Fi N as well as the AC band, and the combined speed is 1900 megabits. That's why the name 1900. And on the 2.4 gigahertz band, it supports speeds up to 600 megabits per second, and on the AC up to 1300 megabits per second. That's almost 1.3 gigabits. And it says that it has ultimate range. Let me just zoom in a little bit. And it says that it's dual band, as I said, 2.4 gigahertz as well as the 5 gigahertz band. And it also has beamforming technology. So it'll concentrate the signal where your devices are. And it has a USB 3 port. It has 4 gigabit ports, advanced security, and it supports actually a dual core processor that's clocked at 1.2 gigahertz. And in terms of RAM, it has 256 MB DDR3 RAM, which is kind of huge because many of the Wi-Fi routers don't even have 32 megabytes of RAM. And it also has 128 megabytes of flash storage. And it has four antennas that are performance antennas, it says, and it's also open source ready. And it also has a eSATA port. And it has to be one of the most heavily specced router. Again, some specification. We also have a mobile app for this, using which you can control this router. So let's just quickly open this up and let's have a look. And we have the router itself. And the first thing I have to say, the packaging is also very nice, and it's a very big and a very, very heavy router. I've reviewed a lot of routers and tested them, but this is a pretty big router. Let me keep that to the side. We also have the quick start guide, and let us open this one, and it just gives us an idea about how to set up the router, and also says not to keep anything on the top because it supports a pretty powerful dual core processor. It might generate heat, so you should not keep anything on the router. And it gives and here it gives me the Wi-Fi pre-network password and ID. And we also have a CD-ROM here and a quick start guide. So let me keep these things to the side. And further down, we have the four detachable antennas. Actually, you don't need to attach all the antennas, but here are the detachable antennas, and these are actually flexible, as you can see. So these are the four antennas that we have. Let me take these out also. And going further down, we have all the accessories. This is the flat type Ethernet cable. And again, it's a gigabit cable. We also have the power cable. And this is the power brick. The power brick is also actually pretty huge. And again, it's a Linksys branded one. And it outputs up to 4 amps, and input is 100 to 240 volts. So it will work worldwide. And let's see what we have in this small box also. Nothing else. So that's what we get in the box. So let me keep all these things to the side, and let's look at the router itself. And as I told you, it's a huge router. It's pretty big. And on the front, we have status LEDs and the model number, that is the WRT 1900 AC, it says. And obviously these will glow when we power it on. And we have all the status LEDs, like for internet, 2.4 gigahertz band, 5 gigahertz band, eSATA port, USB 1 USB 2, and this are for the four Ethernet ports. On the top again, as I said, a lot of vents to dissipate the heat. And we have the antenna here. We'll have four. One you can attach over here, another over here, another over here, and lastly the fourth one over here. Moving towards the back, we have the WPS dedicated switch, and these are four Ethernet ports. Again, these are gigabit ports, and also we have a WAN port. Again, this is also a gigabit port. We also have a USB 3 port over here, and this is also USB 2 compatible. And also we have one more USB port, that is a USB 2 come a eSATA port. And we also have a reset switch, and here your power adapter will go. We also have a physical on off switch here. So pretty beefy router, and let me attach the antennas and I'll be back. And this is how this Linksys AC1900 router looks after adding all the antennas, and the antennas are flexible. And I have to say, this has to be one of the biggest Wi-Fi routers that I have tested. To give you an idea, let me bring back this original WRT54G. And I had this router for about 10 years. It's still working. I'm using it as a repeater. And to give you an idea, look at the size. This new WRT1900 AC is pretty big, and also it's actually pretty heavy. You can also add portable hard drive via the USB port at the back to this router, and this router has built-in support for DLNA, so you can stream stuff directly from the hard drive to your DLNA enabled devices using this router. Now coming to the pricing, as some of you might have already guessed it, it's a pretty high-end router, and the pricing also reflects that. It has to be one of the most expensive consumer grade Wi-Fi routers out there, and in US it's selling for around US$299. So I'll be testing this router for the next couple of weeks. I'll be doing in-depth test on it, range test, and also give you an idea about its user interface, etc. So thank you for watching this unboxing video for this Linksys WRT1900 AC. I'll be doing an in-depth review for this router in the next couple of weeks. So if you aren't subscribed to my YouTube channel, subscribe to the same. Thank you for watching this video. This is Ranjit, and I hope to see you in my next video.